Hello coders, I welcome you all to project 9. In this project, we are going to work with a very well-known real-world dataset, IMDb movie dataset, available on Kaggle. You can download this dataset from Kaggle. Link is given in the description of this video. So in this project, with frequently used techniques like head, tail, etc. Also, we are going to discuss other important techniques for data analysis and data visualization. I request you to watch up to the end. I am sure you will learn something. So let's get started. As you can see over here, we are going to use this dataset that you can download from here. Just click on this download button and press OK. As you can see over here, our dataset is available in CSV format. So let's load this dataset into our Jupyter notebook. So first, let me import pandas as PD. For data visualization, I am going to import seaborn as SNS. Also, matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, our required libraries are successfully imported. So now let's load our data set. So let me write data equal to pd.read_CSV, and our dataset name is imdb-movie-data.csv. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, our dataset is successfully imported. To explain you data analysis and data visualization on this IMDb movie dataset, here I have mentioned some questions that you can see over here. So let's solve them one by one. So question number one. So in this question, we have to display top 10 rows of the data set. That we can do with data which is pointing to our data set here. Dot head method of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, by default, head method is displaying top 5 rows of the data set that you can see over here, 0 to 4. But as per our question, we have to display top 10 rows of the data set. So here we can pass integer argument. Let me pass 10. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now this head method is displaying top 10 rows of the data set that you can see over here, 0 to 9. So this way we can display top 10 rows of the data set using this head method of pandas data frame. So now next question. So in this question, we have to check last 10 rows of the data set. So for that, we have to write data dot tail method of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, by default, tail method is displaying last 5 rows of our data set that you can see over here. With help of this tail method, also we can check how many entries are available in our data set that you can see over here. But as per our question, we have to check last 10 rows of the data set. So here I am going to pass 10 as an argument to our tail method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now tail method is displaying last 10 rows of our data set that you can see over here. So this way we can check last 10 rows of the data set using tail method of pandas data frame. So now our next question. So in this question, we have to find shape of our data set, means number of rows and number of columns available in our data set. That we can do with data dot shape attribute of pandas data frame. As you can see over here, shape is not a method, it is an attribute of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, output is tuple. So let's print in proper format using print function of Python. So print number of rows data dot shape. This is at index 0 and this is at index 1. 0. Print number of columns data dot shape 1. This one. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, number of rows, number of columns available in our data set. So this way we can find shape of our data set, means number of rows and number of columns, using shape attribute of pandas data frame that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question, we have to get information about our data set like total number of rows, total number of columns, data types of each column, and memory requirement. That we can do with just one method, info method. So we have to write data.info. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, total we are having this many entries, means total we are having this many rows with these indexes. As you can see over here, column names, this many non-null values in this particular column, this many non-null values in this particular column. Likewise, as you can see over here, data type for each column, D types colon. So in our data set, we are having three columns with floating point data type, four columns with integer data type, five columns with object data type, that you can see over here. And memory usage, 93.9 plus KB required for our data set. So this way we can get information about our data set, like total number of rows, total number of columns, data types of each column, and memory requirement using info method of pandas data frame, that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we are going to check missing values in the data set. Let's first check, is there any missing value in our data set? Yes or no? We are interested in Boolean answer, true or false. So for that, let me write print any missing value and data dot is null method of pandas data frame dot values attribute dot any method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, output is true, means our data set contains some missing values. So now let's check which columns are having missing values. So for that we have to write data dot is null method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, data frame is generated with Boolean values, true and false. So now let's find sum of true values using this sum method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, missing values are in two columns, revenue and metascore, that you can see over here. It is always better practice to visualize it. We can visualize missing values using Seebohm's heat map. So for that we have to write SNS dot heat map. Here we have to pass data dot is null method of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying heat map. And as you can see, heat map is showing some missing values in lighter color in this revenue and metascore column, that you can see over here. So this way we can visualize missing values using Seebohm's heat map, that you can see over here. So now let's find missing values in percentage. So I am going to create one variable, per underscore missing, equal to data dot is null method of pandas data frame dot sum method multiply by 100 divided by length of our data frame. So let's print this variable per underscore missing. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, around 13% values are missing in this revenue column. Around 7% values are missing in this metascore column. So this way we can check missing values in our data set, that you can see over here. So now next question. So we are going to drop all the missing values. So for that we have to write data dot drop any method of pandas data frame. Let me pass axis is equal to 0. So by default, value of axis in this drop any method is 0. So axis is equal to 0 means drop rows which contain missing values. Axis is equal to 1 means drop columns which contain missing value. By default, value of this axis is 0. So now if we want to modify our existing data frame, then we have to write in place parameter is equal to true. But for teaching learning purpose, I am not modifying the existing data frame, but you can do that. So let me remove this in place parameter and let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, missing values are dropped, that you can see over here. So this way we can drop all the missing values using drop NA method of pandas data frame. So now next question. So in this question, we are going to check for duplicate values in our data set. So for that, we have to write data dot duplicated method of pandas data frame dot any method. Let me assign this statement to one variable dup underscore data equal to this statement. Let me execute this cell. So let me print, are there any duplicate values? And here is our variable dup underscore data. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, answer is false, means there is no any duplicate value in our data set. So if it is there, then we can drop using data dot drop underscore duplicates method of pandas data frame, and to modify our existing data frame we can assign back. Let me print data. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, this way we can handle duplicate values in our data set. Please remember, we do not have any duplicate value in our data set. If it is there, then we can drop like this. So now next question. So in this question, we have to get overall statistics about our data frame or our data set. That we can do with data dot describe method of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying statistics about our data set like count, mean, means average, standard deviation, minimum value, and these are percentile 25%, 50%, 75% and maximum value. As you can see over here, minimum and maximum values in year shows the minimum and maximum release years. So we can see that the dataset contains movies from 2006 to 2016. As you can see over here, average rating is about 6.7. As you can see over here, minimum rating is 1.9 and maximum rating is 9.0. As you can see over here, the maximum revenue earned by movie is this one. So this way we can find overall statistics about our data frame or our data set. So please remember, by default this describe method is displaying statistics for numerical columns only. If we want for all the columns, categorical as well as numerical columns, then we have to write include is equal to all. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying statistics for categorical as well as numerical columns. So this way we can get overall statistics about our data set or our data frame using this describe method of pandas data frame. So now next question. In this question, we have to display title of the movie having runtime greater than equal to 180 minutes. So let me first display column names using data dot columns to know actually we have to work on which column. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying column names. Please remember, columns is not a method, it is an attribute of pandas data frame. So now let me write data in bracket notation runtime column. Let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. And here we are going to use filtering greater than equal to 180. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying series with boolean values. So let me pass this boolean series to our data frame. It will display rows where this condition become true. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, so as per our question, we have to display title of the movie having runtime greater than equal to 180 minutes. So we are interested in title. So here let me write title. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying title of the movie having runtime greater than equal to 180 minutes, that you can see over here. So this way we can display title of the movie having runtime greater than equal to 180 minutes, that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question, we have to find in which year there was the highest average voting. So let me display column names using data dot columns to know actually we have to work on which column. Let me execute this cell. So here we can use group by method. So let me write data dot group by year, this year column. And as per our question, we have to find highest average voting. So we have to work on this votes column. So let me copy this column name. Let me paste it over here. Dot mean to find the average. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying this result. But as per our question, we have to find in which year there was the highest average voting. So we have to sort these values. For that, we can use sort underscore values method of pandas data frame. And by default, sort underscore values sort our data in ascending order. To sort in descending order, we have to write this ascending parameter to false. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, highest voting was in year 2012. That you can see from this result. It is always better practice to visualize it. We can visualize this using Seebohn's bar plot. So let me write SNS dot bar plot. On x-axis I am going to pass year. On y-axis I am going to pass votes column and data which is pointing to our original data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now let's decorate this graph. So let me give title using plt.title votes by year. Let me execute this cell. To remove this statement, let me write plt.show. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, highest average voting was in year 2012. That you can see from this graph. So please remember, we can use this bar plot for displaying relationships between categorical data and at least one numerical variable. So this way we can find in which year there was the highest average voting, that you can see here. So now next question. In this question we have to find in which year there was the highest average revenue. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So now we can solve this question same way that we have solved this one. So let me copy this statement and let me paste it over here. So in place of these votes, we have to pass this revenue column. So let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, highest revenue was in year 2009. It is always better practice to visualize it. So let me copy these statements and let me paste it over here. So in place of these votes, we have to pass this revenue column. So let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. So let me change this title to revenue. Let me execute this cell once again. As you can see over here, highest revenue was in year 2009. That you can see from this bar graph. So now next question. In this question, we have to find the average rating for each director. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So now we have to work on this director and on this rating columns. We can solve this question using group by method of pandas data frame. Group by this director column. So let me copy and paste it over here. And we have to find average rating. So let me copy this rating column and let me paste it over here. To find average, we have to use this min method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So this way we can find average rating for each director, that you can see over here. If we want to sort in ascending or descending order, we can use sort underscore values method. By default, this sort underscore values perform sorting in ascending order. If you want in descending order, then we have to write this ascending to false. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, our data in descending order by this rating. So this way we can find average rating for each director, that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question we have to display top 10 lengthy movies title and runtime. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this title and this runtime column. So I am going to use n largest method of pandas data frame. Let's check docstring of this method. This n largest method returns the first n rows ordered by columns in descending order. So here I am passing 10 because we want to display top 10 lengthy movies title and runtime. So now here I am going to pass this runtime column. Let me copy and paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying this data frame as per this highest runtime, that you can see over here. But as per our question, We are interested in title and runtime column. So now in today list, I am going to pass this title column and this runtime column. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying this data frame. As you can see over here, it is showing this default indexes. So I am going to make this title as our data frame index. So let me write in new line. So for that, I am going to use dot set underscore index method. I am going to make this title column as our index column. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, so let me assign this to one variable, top 10 underscore len equal to this statement. As you can see over here, our data frame. So this way we can display top 10 lengthy movies title and runtime that you can see over here. So now it is always better practice to visualize it. So we can visualize it using bar plot. Please remember, we can use bar plot for displaying relationships between categorical data and at least one numerical variable. So let me use SNS dot bar plot. On x-axis, I am going to pass this runtime column. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. On y-axis, I am going to pass this title column. But please remember, now title is our index column. So we can access using top 10 underscore len, which is pointing to our data frame here, dot index, to access index of this data frame, means this title, and data is equal to our data frame, this one. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying nice bar plot that you can see over here. So this way we can display top 10 lengthy movie titles and runtime that you can see over here. On x-axis, we are having runtime. On y-axis, we are having titles that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we have to display number of movies per year. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this year column. So let me write data and year, and we can use value counts method of pandas data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying number of movies per year that you can see over here. So now please remember, this value counts method returns object containing counts of unique values. The resulting object will be in descending order that you can see over here. So the first element is the most frequently occurring element that you can see from this result. So let's visualize this. So for that, I am going to use Seebohm's count plot. On x-axis, let me pass year and data which is pointing to our original data frame. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, this way we can display number of movies per year that you can see from this graph. Let's decorate this graph. So let me give title using plt dot title. So let me write number of movies per year. Let me execute this cell. To remove this line, let me write plt dot show. Let me execute this cell once again. As you can see over here, so this way we can display number of movies per year that you can see from this graph. So now next question. In this question, we have to find most popular movie title as per highest revenue. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this revenue column. So let me write data in bracket notation. I am going to pass this revenue column. So let me copy and paste it over here. So let me find max value in this revenue column using max method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying maximum value from this revenue column. So as per our question, we have to find most popular movie title as per highest revenue. So I am going to compare this maximum value with other values in this revenue column. So let me copy and paste it over here. So let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying series with Boolean values. So let me pass it to our data frame. Let me execute this cell. Now it is displaying rows where this condition become true that you can see over here. And we are interested in title. So let me write here title column. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying most popular movie title as per highest revenue that you can see over here. So this way we can find most popular movie title as per highest revenue that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we have to display top 10 highest rated movie titles and its directors. So now this is almost same that we have solved over here. So let me copy this code. Let me paste it over here to save our recording time. So let me display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So as per our question, we have to display top 10 highest rated movie titles and its director. So we have to use this column rating. So let me copy and let me replace this runtime with rating. Let me replace this runtime with rating and let me pass here this director column. Let me copy and paste it over here. Let me execute this cell top 10 underscore len. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now title is our index column, and as you can see over here, rating and director. So this way we can display top 10 highest rated movie titles and its director that you can see from here. So now it is always better practice to visualize it. So for that, let me use sns.barplot. On x-axis, I am going to pass this rating column. On y-axis, we have to pass this title. So let me copy this data frame name and dot index to access title from this data frame, which is our index column, and data which is pointing to our data frame, this one, top 10 underscore len. Let me execute this cell, as you can see over here. So this way we can display top 10 highest rated movies and its director. But in this graph, it is showing rating and title. So now let me use hue parameter, and here I am passing director column. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, our bars are looking very thin. So for that, I am going to use this dodge parameter to false. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is looking better. So now let's move this legend over here outside of this graph. So for that, we have to use plt.legend method of matplotlib. So let me press shift tab to check docstring of this legend method. I am going to use this parameter bbox_2_anchor. So we can put legend arbitrary using this argument of legend method. So let me copy this. Let me close this. Let me paste it over here. Equal to, we can set any position as per our requirement. So let me write 1.05, 1. And also we have to set location. Let me set it to 2. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it's look better. So now it is displaying rating, title and director. So this way we can display top 10 highest rated movies titles and its director that you can see from this bar graph. So now next question. In this question, we have to display top 10 highest revenue movie titles. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this revenue column. So let me use once again n largest method of pandas data frame, and let me pass 10 comma this revenue column. So let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying 10 rows sorted by this revenue column. So now as per our question, we have to display top 10 highest revenue movie titles. So we are interested in title column only. So let me execute this cell, as you can see over here. So this way we can display top 10 highest revenue movie titles that you can see over here. So now it is always better practice to visualize it. So let me copy this statement and let me paste it over here. So let me copy this revenue column and let me paste it over here. And we have to pass this in 2D list. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying title and revenue that you can see over here. So now I am going to make this title column as our index column. So dot, let me write in new line, set underscore index to our title. Let me execute this cell, as you can see over here. So let me assign this to one variable, top underscore 10. equal to this statement. Let me execute this cell. Let me display this data frame, as you can see over here. Now, to visualize this, I am going to use Seaborn's bar plot. On x-axis, I am going to pass this revenue column. So let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. On y-axis, I am going to pass this title. Please remember, title is our index column. So here we have to write top underscore 10, which is pointing over here to our data frame. This one, we can access index using index attribute of pandas data frame, and data which is pointing to our data frame, this one, top underscore 10. So let me write top underscore 10. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying top 10 highest revenue movie titles that you can see over here. As you can see over here, on x-axis revenue, on y-axis it is displaying titles. So now let's add title to this graph using title method of matplotlib. So let me write top 10 highest revenue movie titles. Let me execute this cell. To remove this statement, let me write plt.show. Let me execute this cell once again. As you can see over here, top 10 highest revenue movie titles that you can see over here. So this way we can display top 10 highest revenue movie titles that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we have to find average rating of movies year wise. So let me first display column names. To know, actually we have to work on which column. So as per our question, we have to work on this rating column. So we have to find average rating of movies year wise. So I am going to use group by method. Group by year wise and rating dot mean. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying average rating of movies year wise that you can see over here. Also, we can sort using sort underscore values method of pandas data frame. By default, it performs sorting in ascending order. For descending, we have to set this ascending parameter to false. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, this way we can find average rating of movies year wise that you can see over here. So now next question. So here we have to find answer of this question. Does rating affect the revenue? So let me first display column names. To know, actually we have to work on which column. So now I am going to plot scatter plot of Seaborn. On x-axis, I am going to pass this rating. Let me copy and paste it over here. On y-axis, I am going to pass this revenue column. Let me copy and paste it over here. And data which is pointing to our original data frame. So let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is showing scatter plot. By this scatter plot, we can say that yes, rating does affect the revenue. Rating is high, revenue is also high, that you can see over here. So this way we can answer this question. Does rating affect the revenue? Using scatter plot that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question, we have to classify movies based on ratings, excellent, good and average. So let me first display column names. To know, actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this rating column. So to classify movies based on ratings, we are going to create our own function, means user defined function. So let me write def and rating, which is our function name, and let me pass argument rating. So if rating greater than equal to 7.0, as per your requirement you can change this. Then let me return excellent. Elif rating greater than equal to 6.0, let's return good. Else return average. Let me execute this cell. So let me first write data rating, and we can apply this created user defined function using apply method. And here we have to write function name, this one, rating. So let me write rating. So now let's create new column for this newly created categories. So data, and here you can give any name. So let me write rating underscore cat equal to this statement. Let me execute this cell. So now let's check top 5 rows of our data set using head method. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, new column has been created, and as you can see over here, different categories, excellent, good, likewise. So this way we can classify movies based on ratings, excellent, good, and average, that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question we have to count number of action movies. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So this time we have to work on this genre column. So let me copy this column name and let me paste it over here. So now let's check data type of this column. As you can see over here, it is having object data type. So we can apply string methods. So let me write data and genre column dot str dot contains. So as per our question, we have to count number of action movies. So here we can write action. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, Boolean series is generated. Please remember, this contains method is performing case sensitive search. If we want case insensitive search, then here we have to use case parameter and let me set it to false. So now it will perform case insensitive search. Let me execute this cell. So now let's pass this Boolean series to our data frame. As you can see over here. So as per our question, we have to count number of action movies. So we are interested in count. So I am going to use this length function over here. So let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, output is 303. There are 303 action movies in our data set that you can see over here. So this way we can count number of action movies that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we have to find unique values from genre column. So let me first display column names to know actually we have to work on which column. So we have to work on this genre column. So let me copy and paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, format of values available in this genre column. It is showing 3 genre for 1 movie that you can see over here. Here is 2, here is 3, here is 1, as you can see over here. So now we are going to perform 3 steps to find unique values from genre column. In first step, I am going to split these items by commas. As you can see over here, we are going to add commas over here after each and every items. Main purpose of this step to create one list for all the items. So let me show you this, our first step. In first step, I am going to split this entire items by commas. So let me create one empty list with name list is equal to 1. So for value in data and this genre column. So now let's split these items by comma, this all. So we are going to add comma over here, comma over here, comma over here, likewise. And now let's append these values to our empty list. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, we have created one common 2D list for all the items that you can see over here. So now our second step. So in second step, I am going to convert this 2D list into 1D list to find unique values. So now let me create one empty list with name 1D. So now for item in list 1 that we have just created, that you can see over here, our 2D list, for item 1 in item, and let's append this item 1 to our 1D list. Let me execute this cell. So now let's check our 1D list. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now 2D list is converted into 1D list, and also you can see format of our items. So now our third step. In our third step, we are going to find unique values available in this genre column. So now let me create one empty list, uni underscore list, which is empty list. So I am going to traverse 1D list for item in 1D list. So if item not in this unique list, so as you can see over here, this unique list is empty. And if item not in this unique list, then append this item into this unique list. So if item is not available in this unique list, then only append the item that will find unique values from this 1-day list. So let me execute this cell. So now let's check our unique list, as you can see over here. So this way we can find unique values from genera column. So let me find length of this list. So total we are having 20 unique values in this genera column. But as per our question, we are interested in find unique values from genera column. So let me remove this length function. We are interested in this answer that you can see over here. So this way we can find unique values from genera column that you can see over here. So now our final question. In this question, we have to find how many films of each genre were made. So now I am going to use this 1-day list. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. Please remember, we are going to use this 1-day list that we just created. So now let's check content of this 1-day list, as you can see over here, our 1-day list. So now, as per our question, we have to find how many films of each genre were made. So I am going to use collections package. So from collections, import counter module. Let me execute this cell. So I am going to apply this counter module on 1D list. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, this way we can find how many films of each genre were made. 303 action movies, 259 adventure movies, 120 sci-fi movies, that you can see over here. So this way we can find how many films of each genre were made, that you can see over here. So here we have used counter module of this collections package, that you can see over here. So please don't forget to subscribe this channel. If you like this video, smash that like button. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care. Bye bye. See you in the next video.